most think I'm an idiot.
Ridiculous, pitiful, embarrassing, stupid, dumb, waste of time. That's just a few of the thoughts that come to my mind when discussing the Tennessee Titans' performance against the Jacksonville Jaguars live on national television last Thursday night.
Fatality.
We was live on a national stage, trying to prove that we belong with the big boys. And what do? Give me a break. Everybody wondering why we don't get respect. Well, now you see why we don't get respect. We got beat out by a 6-round draft pick. Only thing cool about him is that mustache. Ain't gonna lie, I kinda like him.
Check on the list of bombastic.
But anyway, this ain't about him. It's about the Tennessee Titans' deficiencies in playing football. Because right now, they got a whole slew of them. All I'm going to say is this. We was embarrassing on a national stage with the whole country tuned in to watch. Who are we kidding? The whole country tuned in. Give me a break. Only damn people tuned in to that game in their right mind are Titans fans and Jaguars fans. Or maybe some fantasy football enthusiasts. But there really ain't too many players on both those teams that you should have on your fantasy football squad. Trust me, all right? We got some issues, and we got some problems, and we gotta fix them pronto. And Taylor Lewan, I'm looking at you. When you get back on this team, you better whip this line into shape. Because if you don't, it's gonna be a long season.
Finish him.
Now, I ain't gonna say too much about the Jacksonville Jaguars. They whooped their butts. They earned it. And I ain't gonna make fun of them no more. Because our winning streak against them is kaput. We're going to have to start a new winning streak. And even though we might beat them for the next 18 games, we could. Because, I mean, Jacksonville kind of sucks most of the time. I ain't going to talk too much trash. Because right now, I got egg on my face. Not literally, in a figuratively sense. If I literally had egg on my face, there would be egg dripping down my face. Okay? And look, I know we got some issues with the line. All right? I ain't 100% blaming Marcus. We had 9 sacks. I would say about 5 or 6 of them were his fault because he's once again holding on the ball like it's super glued to his damn hands. So Marcus, I'm going to give you a pass on a few things. But I tell you what I'm not going to give you a pass on. How are you missing open receivers 10 yards from you in the end zone and you're a 5th-year quarterback? How? I can make those throws. Seriously, I probably could. I only played flag football once at MTSU when I was back in college, but I was pretty good. And yeah, I played football once when I was a kid in 8th grade. We didn't win a game all season. And one game that we came super close to winning, it was my fault that we lost. All right, but guess what? I owned it and I didn't make excuses. But enough about my legacy as a football player. We're talking about the Tennessee Titans. And right now, y'all gonna have to turn around against the Dirty Birds. Because if we're staring at 1-3, going to play the Buffalo Bills, and that defense, it's gonna be a long season. We got a lot of work to do to climb out this hole. We're in the bottom of the AFC South. We're the cellar dwellers. Okay? Colts looking good. Texans looking good. You know what I saw in both those games? I saw a steady offensive line, and I saw stellar QB play. That's 2 things we're lacking. We can't get King Henry going, because we can't get out of the pocket, because they're sending the whole damn team, because they know we can't block them. We can't get the ball downfield to our receivers, because Marcus doesn't know how to throw a football. Okay? Let's be real about this. It's 5 years later, and he still can't throw a ball. He still can't hit an open receiver. Is that the OC's fault? Nope. Is that the revolving door of coaches' fault? Nope. Is that Bigfoot's fault? Nope. It's Marcus' fault. because he ain't that good of a quarterback, okay? When it comes to athlete, he's tremendous. One of the best. Let's be real. We've all seen his stiff arms. All you people want to do is post animated GIFs of his stiff arms. Like, that defines him as a real quarterback. No, that defines him as a running back. If he wants to be a running back, then by all means, be a running back. But I, for one, want to see a quarterback wearing two-tone blue, and I know you do too. Because we've passed on a bunch of them. Jared Goff. Remember that time we could have drafted him number one? That was cute. Two, Carson Wentz. Would've been nice to see him on the Titans. What's another guy? That guy talks like Kermit the Frog. Patrick Mahomes. Yeah, I think I'd like to see him wearing Titans jersey. Even Deshaun Watson, our rival from the Texans. Marcus Mariota ain't half the quarterbacks that these dudes are. I'm serious, and you know it. And part of the problem is you won't admit it. Y'all think the Marcus haters just want to be right. But the truth is, the Marcus supporters don't want to admit that they might be wrong. That's what's really going on here. But look, I'm going to move past that, all right? And I'm going to talk about the game. Because we got to handle the Dirty Birds. We need our secondary to be the best in the business this Sunday. Because you got Uncle Julio coming to town. Mr. Calvin Ridley. Fight. And Mohamed Sanu.
Finish him.
Three of the best wide receivers in the game on the same damn team. And they got a big white boy tied in by the name of Austin Hooper.
Fatality.
He got two touchdowns last week. So our boys are going to have to be up for the challenge. Because we all know our offense might not put up more than 20 points. We need the defense to hold them, once again, 20 points. Because our defense is the reason why we win most of the games. It sure as hell ain't our offense. Until Arthur Smith figures it out and Marcus Mariota gets his head out of his I don't know what to say. But I'm confident that we can turn it around. The season ain't over. We still got divisional opponents. We still get to play the Texans twice. We still get to get revenge against the Colts and the Jaguars. But right now, I'm not so sure this team can do it. I have confidence in them, but they don't give me confidence when I'm watching them. It's like Monday through Saturday, I feel good about it. And about 7 minutes into the football game, I start getting sick to my stomach and I want to throw up. Now, even though we know Atlanta has a nice offense, they got a pretty mediocre defense. So if our offense could put up just some numbers and our defense can keep Maddie at bay, then I think we can steal a victory. I really think we do. I'll be honest, at the beginning of the year, when I saw the Falcons on there in week four, I was like, that might be our first loss of the season. But if we can make it through these four games, 2-2, without Taylor Lewan, that's something to build on. Now, it sucks that we lost two divisional games, because those are the ones that we really needed to win. We can still turn this thing around, all right? But if we lose two or three more games in the next five or six, we are in trouble. We'll be drowning. Ain't nobody gonna throw us a life preserver. They're just gonna keep laughing at us. And I fully expect management to make a move at QB if Marcus keeps struggling. Because if Marcus keeps playing the way he is, they're not gonna re-sign him. So why would you spend the rest of the year evaluating his progress? Because you already know what you got. All right, he's not like a transfer student from a new school. You're trying to let him adjust. He's a fifth-year quarterback that we drafted to be a superstar. And right now he's getting outplayed by six-round draft picks with porn star mustaches. All right, tighten up.